In this video today, guys, I'm going to be talking to you about why Christian women need to stop over-spiritualizing toxic relationships and partners. Guys, it's a happy day. Paige is free. God has exposed the toxic, manipulative, and even some might say narcissistic traits that we have seen all these weeks in Chris. They come in the church and you'll find them outside of the church. They will claim to be a man of God or a woman of God, but they can still be a toxic, manipulative, dangerous individual. Let's address that. Let's not try to hyper-spiritualize, because this is what happens. I think we hyper-spiritualize things and then it gets kind of brushed under the carpet and you end up in a situation like a Chris and Paige. And guys, if you've not seen Married at First Sight season 12, I hope that many other women watching this will be able to say, you know what? Christianity aside, this is toxic. This is manipulative. Stop putting the ideal of he's a man of God because he says he's Christian in front of it. Don't dress it up. Don't pretty it up. A toxic person is a toxic person. They come in the shape of being part of the Christian body and they come outside of the Christian body. Don't worry about that. Deal with what you're dealing with, which is a manipulator, a narcissist, or whatever they might be in front of you. I'm going to first talk about an interview that Paige actually recently did with Bossip. I won't read through the whole interview. There's a really good question they asked her near the end of the interview, guys. And it says, we've seen your strong faith keep you calm throughout this entire ordeal, and you've handled things with such class and grace. What do you think God wanted you to learn through this process? Now, Paige goes on to say, I've seen a lot of commentary circulating around, God would not support this mess. That was the quote. Or not bring my religion in my struggle. The ironic part about all of this is I felt like God had given up on me because of all the disparities that I had been facing throughout my process. I was journaling during my experience, and in the beginning, I was questioning God for bringing me into this experience. And then I started to shift my prayers to become gratitude-based. And I just started to see an overall shift in my perspective of life. The biggest lesson I think he wanted me to learn throughout this process is not to rush him and to let things happen on his time. This process confirmed the healing and transformative work that needs to be done in order to truly be ready for marriage. Now, guys, I thank the good Lord that this young lady had so much sense downloaded into her at this very last moment that says, yes, there is something positive that does come out of this experience. And that is, one, you do not need to rush the process. Don't rush God. Like, I know it's about being proactive. Even when it comes to dating, there are things and steps we can be taking. But when you try to rush and force the hand of God to bring forth a Boaz that truly is not sent by him, you actually are placing yourself in a very dangerous situation. There's a really good scripture in the Bible, and it's Proverbs 21 verse 5, and I'm reading it in the New Living Translation. Good planning and hard work lead to prosperity, but hasty shortcuts lead to poverty. I know this is a scripture normally applied to finances, but this is also applicable to achieving a healthy relationship. As Christian women or Christian men, really do need to think about how we go about trying to sometimes force something that is not for us. And in this instance, Paige said she was seeing and experiencing struggle from the jump when it came to this process. She said she felt like God had given up on her. Okay, that it would be great if they unpicked. In what way do you feel like God had given up on you? But what she then goes on to say is the fact that ironic part of it all is I felt like God had given up on me because of all the disparities that I had been facing throughout my process. So what I now came away thinking was, oh, maybe she had a lot of obstacles in terms of with this whole process with Married at First Sight. Maybe things weren't smooth sailing at the start. Maybe there was a lot of hurdles and things that just seemed to be almost blocking her opportunity to actually get to be selected and matched with someone. And now we come to find out it's Chris. And this just led me to say, you know what? This is sometimes how God will step in and intervene, divine intervention into your scenario. And you're thinking, whoa, why are so many things against me? I've just been struggling, battling, nothing's working my way. But it's God, it's the divine intervention from God himself saying, listen, because I love you, because you matter to me, because you're my child, I am actually intervening to save you. I'm going to save you from your own self, because the decisions you are making are actually dangerous. They're going to lead you down a path that is not going to be prosperity, but it's going to be poverty. Now, guys, I'm not here as a preacher. Lord knows, I don't have any preaching qualifications, but what I am saying is, when I watched this, I literally was like, Lord, this is a common problem. Sometimes God is saying, no, don't do that thing. And it sounds like she was already getting these signs of don't do this, or this isn't for you, from the jump. And this is a perfect example of how we end up sometimes in the type of relationship that can be so detrimental to our emotional and mental well-being, and we are gung-ho on holding on to it. But in all fairness, had Chris not said divorce, we would still be here seeing this play out, I'm pretty sure. And that is sometimes just how far God will go. He will say, listen, if you can't leave yourself after seeing the list of red flags, of problems, of toxicity, of manipulation, sometimes I really believe like God will use the very same thing that you're so determined to stay with, and he'll say, okay, I'll get that person to remove themselves. You're still longing for them, but God had to do it in that way because he knew you did not have the strength to leave. I think I see this so often in women who are part of the Christian faith, who do seek to be in a loving marriage, and they have this idealized, you know, hope that their husband's going to come to them and he's going to be all these wonderful qualities and things, and there's nothing wrong with that. But the problem is because of the idolized idea of marriage and that person who you've created, and we all sometimes have a hope of who that kind of individual might be, we cling to toxic relationships because sometimes we are, of course, we've made those vows, so we want to honor the vows that we've made before God, but sometimes we're hopeful for this ideal person and this ideal marriage to come to fruition. We're hoping it's going to actually manifest itself. So we cling, we're holding on to trash, quite frankly, trash, guys, toxic, manipulative, and even narcissistic traits in partners that are damaging to our emotional and mental well-being. We then over-spiritualize it. We use terms like, you know, he's a man of God, or we'll use terms like, you know, God never puts more in us than we're able to bear. We find all the language to pretty up abuse. We find all the language to pretty up manipulation. We find all the language to pretty up psychological warfare and harm that is being done to us. And that is why I want to use this video to really highlight the importance as a Christian, whether you're a woman or a man watching this, and even if you're not part of that faith, the importance of not trying to over spiritualize or look over and look past toxic, manipulative behavior from partners. Because the impact of that over time, this lady in her interview says the experience was traumatic. She said, at times, I wasn't even present. She was emotionally checked out. This is her interview with Bossip, guys. You know, one of the things she says is in the interview, she says, I knew my spirit was really uneasy on the wedding day, but I still wanted to give things a fair chance. Woo! Guys, the Holy Spirit, when you're of this faith, the Holy Spirit will quietly whisper, or it will communicate with you. And if you don't get a sense of peace sometimes, you need to pay attention to that. You need to lean into that rather than distance yourself from that. Shut that off. No, God. I didn't hear you just tell me run. No, God. I didn't hear you just tell me. Yeah, he's a narcissist. And that's why going on a show like Married at First Sight, trying to jump the steps because you've not done the healing work. This is how you can end up in a situation like this. You know, the Bible talks about he who finds a wife, okay? Now, true love has boundaries. I really need to say that because sometimes people assume that like, oh, if I have to say no or I have to set a boundary with my husband or my spouse, sometimes that can be a bit uncomfortable. But true love has boundaries. Now, when you don't have good boundaries, or when you don't have the ability to sometimes check people on things, even your husband, that can be a problem because you go into marriage and you almost feel like, well, he's my husband. I can't really say too much, or I don't want to offend. And you have this mindset that your voice and your boundaries, they just go out the window because actually I need to respect my husband. And yes, you do need to respect your husband. Equally, respect goes two ways. And when you maybe have not had the healthiest experience of love, that can be one of the areas that you want to gain a better understanding of what a healthy, loving, and healthy relationship looks like. So that when you actually come up against dating or even marrying a stranger and deciding to marry someone like a Chris, and you've not really done enough self-work, the work on yourself to really understand who you are, why you might do or think the way you think or put up with things the way you do when you're in these relationships, or why you seem to be drawn to these same emotionally unavailable men or emotionally manipulative men or whatever the common patterns might be. When you've not really done some of that work and then some healing, it can be very dangerous when you just try to go and think, I'm ready to be a wife. And that's the work that I'm so pleased and I hope that Paige is really going away to do, so that when she does have the wonderful blessing of her true Boaz at God's time and they meet, she has all these skill sets. She has all the knowledge and understanding to be able to address unhealthy, manipulative, even toxic, abusive behaviors quickly. So guys, make sure you check out our new merch. We've got healthy relationships only mugs. This is a great reminder, guys, that you want to be moving in the direction of healthy relationships. I posted the link in the description below, so grab yourself your mug. I hope you've enjoyed this video, guys. Make sure you hit that like button and the subscribe and the bell so you never miss another video each and every time I upload. Take care and God bless. Bye.